Happy Mother's Day, everyone. If we have any mamas watching with us, I just want to wish you a very, very happy Mother's Day. We certainly could not do life without you. Thank you so much for all the love, time, energy, effort you put into each one of us, into raising up the next generation as followers of Jesus. Thank you so much for what you do. Kids, good morning. If you didn't know it already, it is Mother's Day. It's a day where we shower our mamas with love and affection and tell them how much we're thankful for them. So if you have not already, make sure you make some time today to talk to your mama, to let her know how much you appreciate her, how much you love her, how much you couldn't do anything without her, right? And so just make sure you're intentional today about loving on your mama some. And hey, maybe come up with a list of ways that you love her, right? Or things that you're thankful for that she does. Sit down and put some thought into it. I promise you, your mama does a lot for you and around your house and in your life, right? And so do that, right? Or maybe there's another person in your life who does that for you. Maybe it's a grandma or an aunt or even a friend, right? Find somebody in your life today that you can love on and that you can show how much you care about them today. You know, thinking about mamas today and what the Bible says about parents, one of the things that we see the most is the Bible commands us over and over again to be obedient to our parents. What does obedience mean? Simply put, it means doing what somebody else tells you to do. Right? I mean, that's a fairly simple idea, but the Bible over and over again, we see examples in stories. We even see specific commands directly from God to be obedient to our parents. But be honest with me for just a minute. Is that really easy to do? No, I don't think so. If you're like my kids or even like me when I was a kid, sometimes being obedient to your parents is really, really hard. And we don't like to do it. But let me ask you a question. What about when our parents tell us to do something we don't like? Or maybe our parents tell us to do something that we think is unfair. What do we do in that situation? Well, I want us to look at an example of actually from Jesus's life. So check out this cool story.
Every year, Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem to celebrate the Passover. When Jesus was 12 years old, his family traveled to Passover along with many other families, as they always had before. When the celebration was over, Mary and Joseph started to return home.
Joseph, do you know where Jesus is?
He was with my cousin's family last time I saw him.
After traveling all day, Mary and Joseph realized Jesus wasn't with any of their friends or relatives. They were very worried and started back to Jerusalem, looking for him all along the way.
Where is my son?
By the time they got back to Jerusalem, it was nighttime, too late to look for Jesus. The next day, they searched all around the big city.
I'm looking for a boy about this tall.
But couldn't find Jesus anywhere. Another night came without any sign of him. On the third day of their search, Mary and Joseph were walking past the temple, a place where God's people went to worship. Coming from inside the temple, they heard a familiar voice. They rushed inside, and there was young Jesus, talking with some teachers, just like he was one of them. He asked them questions. He answered theirs. His mother had a question too.
Son, why did you stay behind? We were worried about you.
Oh, you should have known. I must be where my father's work is.
Man, that's a pretty cool story, isn't it? You know, we don't often think about Jesus as a boy, but he was a boy, a kid, just like you guys are. In this story, it says that he was around 12 years old. And what happened? Right, his family went to Jerusalem, and then when his family left, they couldn't find Jesus. And eventually, his parents go back into town, they look for him, and they find him in the temple. Right? What do you think his mama and daddy would have thought when they finally find Jesus after looking for him so long? I think they probably were a little bit upset, or either a lot upset at Jesus. Right? But did Jesus really do anything wrong? Not really. But we have to remember here that Jesus wasn't just a normal boy, right? Who was he? Jesus was the Son of God, right? So I'm not saying that anytime you go on vacation that it's okay for you to leave your family behind and stay around, right? Let's probably not do that. But when Jesus did it, it was okay because he was the Son of God. But his parents were still upset at him. But then Jesus said, well, basically, I didn't really do anything wrong. Right? But look what happens next. I want to read to you a little section of scripture here in Luke chapter 2, starting in verse 49. It says, "Why were you searching for me?" Jesus asked. "Didn't you know that I had to be in my Father's house?" But his parents did not understand what he was saying to them. Then he went down to Nazareth with them and was obedient to them. That last part is super important. That's the part I want us to see this morning, is that even though Jesus didn't think he had done anything wrong, and maybe he thought his mom and dad were being a little bit unfair, right? What did he still do? He was still obedient to them. One thing I want to remind you of is Jesus, throughout his whole entire life, even as a 12-year-old boy, Jesus never sinned. Right? So he was never disrespectful or disobedient to his parents, even in a situation like this, when maybe he thought his parents might have been a little bit unfair in this moment, or that Jesus hadn't really done anything wrong. So what does that tell us? That tells us when we face situations where we think our parents might be a little bit unfair, or especially if we face a situation where we don't really like what our parents are doing, what should we do? We should be obedient every single time. After all, remember Ephesians 6:1. What does that say? "Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right." That's a pretty clear statement in the Bible, isn't it? That we have to obey our parents all the time. Even when we don't want to, even when we don't like it, even when we think they're being unfair, the Bible commands us to obey our parents. But let me tell you one more important thing. Do you know why the Bible tells us to obey our parents? Do you know why your mama and your daddy are so passionate about you being obedient to them? Here's a little hint for you. When we obey our parents, or when we learn to obey our parents, that leads us to be obedient to God one day. Let me say that one more time. Obeying your parents now teaches you how to be obedient to God. That's super important. And I know, I'm a parent. I have 4 kids. One of the things that I want them to understand is that when I ask them to be obedient, right, and I tell them to do things, it's not because I want to be mean. It's not because I don't want them to have any fun, right? I want to teach them how to be obedient to me so that one day when they grow up, they know how to be obedient to God. I think that is super important, right? So remember that today is Mother's Day, and my challenge for you is to start today and be thinking all day long about being obedient to your parents, not just your mamas, but your daddies too, right? Try really, really, really hard to be obedient all day long in every situation, even if you don't like it, even if you think it's unfair or you don't want to do it. What does the Bible tell us to do? Ephesians 6:1, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Don't forget to love on your mamas today. Tell them how much you love them and appreciate them. And then don't forget to worship Jesus today. Spend some time as a family singing, reading scripture some today. Spend a lot of time worshiping Jesus and loving on your mamas. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.